Hey everybody, it has been a while since I put a video out. I know life has just gotten a little bit crazy, and in some ways it's kind of gotten a little bit back to normal, and we're just still trying to figure things out. And I just figured it was time for me to get on here and just give you a little bit of a quick update as to what's going on here at New Hope Christian Fellowship, and also just some things that are coming up, and also just to let you know that that I miss you. It's been so nice seeing some of you guys in person on Sunday mornings while we're here outside. And I know a lot of you are choosing to stay away and watch via live stream, and that's okay. But I just want you to know that I miss you, and I can't wait until we can just kind of get back together. And I know we're all just kind of feeling that way, but we're doing the best that we can right now. And I just am asking the Lord to bless us as a church, to bless you, and bless our ministry. And I just want to let you guys know that we're getting ready to take kind of a big jump this Sunday. And a lot of it has to do with the forecast. It's looking like thunderstorms are likely with high humidity and high heat. And so we've decided that we are going to plan on being inside the church this Sunday morning. And that is a big deal. And we're kind of excited about it. And I'm sure that some of you are saying, I'm not sure, if I'm comfortable with that. But let me just kind of, I guess, let you guys know what our plan is. And by the way, when we started meeting, we did put out our guidelines as to what we were doing based on what CDC was asking for churches to do. And so I'm just going to kind of update you and let you know what the expectations are, what you can expect for this Sunday morning. And then if you want to hang around, I want to bring a brief encouragement to you as well at the end of this video. But I know the big thing right now is face covering and masks. And I know that most of the stores are putting their signs up saying, hey, you can't come in without a mask, based on the latest executive order that our governor has put out. And I know that there was a press conference yesterday, and there was something that she had mentioned in regards to businesses, with a few exceptions. And I want to let you know that a house of worship is one of those exceptions to the face mask and the mask covering. I also know that there are people with health concerns, asthma and things like that, that are just really uncomfortable with wearing a face mask. And so here's where we're going to go with this. Because a house of worship is an exception, we are not going to require anybody to wear a face mask as they come in the building on Sunday. And that said, you are more than welcome to wear a face mask if you would like to. Nobody's going to say anything. I think it's kind of the norm now to see people in a face mask. And we're probably going to put some chairs or a section aside where people can be with other people with face masks if you're more comfortable with that, because we want to make provision for everybody and just make sure that everybody's feeling comfortable with this situation. We are spacing the chairs out. We have eliminated chairs in our sanctuary so that we can have social distancing, and we've also set up video in the fellowship hall for overflow. And so I think we've got plenty of space for those that want to join us in the building on Sunday morning. Just like logistical things that we're having to think about, our tithe. We're not going to be passing a tithe basket or the bags that we usually use for tithe. There's going to be one central tithe station where you can just drop your tithe in. And by the way, if you're more comfortable just giving online, there's still that option, allnewhope.org/giveonline, I think is, but there's a tab at the top where it gives you the option to give online. And that said, I just want to say thank you for being faithful to the Lord. God has been so incredible in taking care of us as a church financially. We really have no concerns because He's good, and we've all been faithful and obedient to giving to the Lord. So I just want to say, hey, good job being faithful to the Lord on that. And by the way, giving online is an option, but also watching online is an option. And I know a lot of you guys have stayed home, and you've been very grateful for the live streaming. And that was something that in the very beginning of all of this was just kind of a difficult thing for us to walk through. And I think it's good now because we're reaching people maybe that we wouldn't have reached before. And so pray for us this Sunday, because we have some new equipment in the building that we're going to be using for the very first time. in our live streaming. And we're just praying that everything goes well. We just ask for grace. If things don't go as smoothly as we want them to go, would you please just give us grace? And we're just kind of still walking through this. And, you know, we're just thinking big picture, future. We don't know what the future holds. We don't know if there's going to be, you know, a major second wave, what that's going to mean, you know, for our church and for social gatherings and things like that. But we just really want to be prepared to continue to do ministry as a church. And so we just want to thank you for your grace and for your support as we're walking through this. And it seems weird to say that because the church is really what it should be, supporting people. And, you know, I've seen so many instances of that as we have kind of walked this thing out. And I just got to say, I'm really proud of our church. I'm proud of New Hope Christian Fellowship, and I'm proud of the life groups for continuing to meet. And by the way, that is still just a staple right now, is our life groups. It's good to come together. And, you know, our contact is a little bit limited on Sunday mornings. It probably will be even more so as we come into the building. And so the real connection is happening in life groups. And I want to encourage you, stay connected to your life groups. Stay connected to those people, those that God gave you, to your life group leaders. I'm going to be meeting again with my life group leaders here pretty soon and just bringing some encouragement as we come out of the summer into the fall. I can't believe we're saying that. But God, I believe, has good things in store for us as a church, because Jesus hasn't come back for us yet. We're still on this earth, and we still have a commission that he's given us to present the gospel, to be the light, to be the bride that he's purifying right now. And I pray that during this process of walking through this pandemic and the aftermath, that the Lord is doing great things in your life. And I know for myself, I'm really being stretched in a lot of areas with all of this. And I'm just, you know, thankful that the Lord is full of grace and mercy as we walk through it. And that he's promised never to leave us or forsake us, and he's by our side. And I just am so grateful for that. And by the way, we're reading a lot of that in Joshua, right? And I know last week, Pastor Steve gave a great message out of Joshua. The Lord's given me some things to speak about this Sunday out of Joshua. But it is interesting because the Lord is telling his people, hey, don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. I will be with you wherever you go. And I just want to bring that encouragement to you this morning, that God is with you through this whole thing. And though you may be feeling a lot of emotions, a lot of stress, maybe fear, maybe anger, maybe angst, frustration, whatever it may be, there are also those things that the Lord would give us as fruit of the Spirit, right? He can give us peace and joy and patience through this whole thing. And that will equip us to be the light of the world. And, you know, it was interesting. We were actually at life group last night with our life group, and we were discussing some of the things in Joshua. And one of the main topics that got brought up was, why did God tell the Israelites to go and kill all those people? Like, what's up with that? Like, why would God do that? We understand that God is a loving God, that he is a just God. And, you know, I just want to bring this to you. You may already be very well aware of this, but everything in the Bible, when taken in context, points directly to Jesus, points to him. And if you look at what Jesus did on the cross, he died and paid the sacrifice to completely annihilate and obliterate the things of the world. He totally had victory over the things of the world. He totally has victory over death, over sickness, over just things that we deal with in our life, pride issues, lust issues. He just has victory over these things in our life. And those are all things of the world that we need to be getting rid of. And so as he brought his people into the promised land, he said, hey, you got to get rid of the things of the world. You got to get rid of the things that represent the world. And that's exactly what Jesus did. So when we come into a new life with Christ, we really have to be resolved in our heart to say, I want nothing to do with the things of the world any longer. In fact, I want those things dead and gone in my life, because my life is now in Christ. And I'm so thankful that everything in the Bible points directly to Jesus and what he did for us. He's our Savior. He's our source of peace. He's our source of victory. He's our source of joy, even in these difficult times when Jesus is present in our life. He has all of these wonderful things and blessings for us, and he helps us. He gives us strength. He helps us to maintain. He helps to keep our thoughts sane as we rely on Him and we listen to His voice, as we read His word and we get it in our hearts. That's what we're called to do in these days, and we're called to pray. We're called to pray. Continue to pray. Pray continually, the Bible says. Pray without ceasing. Don't give up praying. Bring your family together. Bring your life group together. Get together with other believers in the body of Christ and pray. Pray through the situation. Pray for strength. Pray that we would not easily be given into fear and things that would overtake us, things that Satan wants to use against us. Let's pray. Let's pray for our government. Let's pray for our president. Let's pray for the church, that the church rises up to be who God has called us to be in this time. There's no mistake that God has called us to live in this time. And He's equipped us to live in this time, to be everything that He has called us to be. And I want to remind you, in those moments where fear starts to come in, where anger and frustration starts to come in, if you would just listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit and pause and say, God, what do you want for me in this moment? How can I glorify you? And how can I keep my thoughts set on the things that you have set before me? You'll be much, much better for it. So I just want to thank you for continuing to press in. I'm looking forward to Sunday. I'm looking forward to giving the message that God has put on my heart for this Sunday. I believe it's going to be an encouragement to us all. And if you want to stay home because we're meeting inside, I understand. If you want to come on out, we'd love to see you. And we're just looking forward to this. Let's continue to press in. And can I just pray for you as I close this video out this morning? God, I just want to lift up these people, Lord, that are watching this video. I lift up our church to you. I lift up New Hope Christian Fellowship. Lord, I lift up our people, our life groups, our families, God, and we ask, Lord, that you would give us strength. God, help us to keep our cool because you're the one that's leading us in our lives. God, I pray that we would be diligent in hiding your word in our hearts and getting the Bible inside of us, Lord, so that we can think the way that you think, that we can act how you act, and we can talk how you talk, Lord. I pray that we would really be the light to the world in this dark place right now, God, that we would be the representation of the love of Christ, Lord, to the people around us. God, there are so many people that are lacking hope in their lives, and I pray that we would gather up the hope that you have given us, Lord, and that we would live it out, that we would offer that hope, and that we would speak the good news. God, help us to be gospel-centered in the things that we say and do every day of our life, we pray. Protect us, God. Keep us safe. Keep us healthy, we pray. Keep our families together, we pray. And I pray that you would unify us as a church. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. I hope to see you on Sunday. Bye.